Everyone, this is Karen from Karen B's Alchemy Acrylic Art. I've had a couple of questions, people asking me, you know, what I actually do when I sell a record, one of my vinyls, to a client. You know, what do you do with the back? My most favorite thing to do is actually just to apply some felt on the back. So I'm just going to kind of go through that today with you. Just do this very quick tutorial so that you can go ahead and do that on your own afterwards. So this is a piece of, it's 2 meters of felt that I purchased at a fabric store. You can actually buy the already cut up into squares type of felt. They sell it in dollar stores and fabric stores and probably Walmart and different stores like that. But they actually don't quite fit a record. They're a little short, which is unfortunate. So I've got these 2 meters for $6. So it's pretty economical. I mean, you can do quite a few records with this, or cover quite a few. So we're just kind of gonna go through that today. So you take your record, your vinyl. I like to put it on the edges as much as I can so I can use the edges. And I just use a black marker, a Sharpie. You can use a colored one, of course, like if you have a white chalk marker, white chalk would probably be better, or something yellow, but I just have my Sharpie today, and that works as well. You can still see the black. You just have to make sure that you really go over it a few times here. Make sure that you can see. That should be good enough. Yep, I can see that very well. Of course, you're going to grab your scissors, and you're just going to go ahead and cut that around. I'm actually going to cut it off of this first. It might be a little bit easier. Okay. So what I like to do is I like to actually go a little bit inside of the line that I made, of the outline, because I don't really like it showing, actually. The felt when you're looking at the record from the front. So I like to kind of go a little bit inside. Okay, that should be fine. You can kind of measure that up if you want. We're just kind of placing it at the back. And you can also trim afterwards, which I normally do anyway. So we'll go through that as well. Okay, so that's good. So the hardest part is actually determining how your client would actually hang this up. So you just kind of have to figure that out for yourself. Not always easy though. Not really sure. I actually think this is the best way here. Okay, so what I do is I just flip it to how I think it should be hung. And the next part is to apply the D-ring, because you want your customer to have something to hang it up with. And the glue that I like to use is this Lepage Contact Cement Heavy Duty Glue. It works for just about anything, and it works instantly, pretty much. But you're going to want to wear gloves when you use that. So the first thing I do is kind of determine where, you know, the little D-ring should go. So about here is about right. I like to put my fabric back on and I kind of figure out where I'm gonna hang it out, and I just kind of gauge a little this way, and I make a little bit of a slit here so that it fits through, so that all you're gonna have is your little ring kind of sticking out. Okay, so I kind of leave it there. Then what I do is I put some gloves on, because this lapage glue is pretty wicked. And it doesn't smell very good either, actually. The cement glue is probably the strongest glue. It's gross. Okay. And what I like about this glue too is that it has a built-in brush, which is really neat. Okay, so what I do is I put my finger on the top of the D-ring here, and I just flip this back, and I flip the little part of the D-ring, and I apply a fair amount of glue underneath the D-ring, then I apply some on the actual record as well, and then I just put that down, I just kind of put it in place, I just kind of hold it for a few seconds. So again, here you're making sure that your fabric is set up nicely. I'm just applying a little bit of pressure here for a little bit. And I keep my finger on it and I just kind of flip my felt halfway over. And then I just apply some of this glue just on the edge, kind of like the very edge. But I try to not actually apply some on the edge, like on the outer edge. I just try and put it very lightly over here. Okay, and once I've got the half done, it's not necessary to put any more anywhere else, just the ledge is good enough. So about an inch or so. And I just kind of pat that down. Okay, then I do the same on the other side. Stuff is really sticky as well. Okay, this is good. Okay, just patting that down a little. Flip her over to pat it down that way if you want. So as you can see, I have a little bit of black showing here of the felt, but that's not a big deal. So I actually like to trim it right away anyways. So you just kind of hold the record up and you can kind of see where it needs trimming. And you just go ahead and do that very quickly. Now you can wait until it dries as well to do this. You don't have to do it right away, but I just like to get it on. Okay, that looks about right. So you want to make sure also when you're doing this that you don't have glue on your gloves. If you do, you want to change them because you don't want to get glue on your actual, the surface of your painting there. So that's it. So you've got your D-ring nice and strong. It'll probably take about just a few hours for it to be really, really solidly dry here. But so I wouldn't hang it up right away. I'd hang it up maybe in 24 hours or so. But yeah, so that's all I do. It's a nice finish for your customer at the back. Nice and clean looking. And that's it. Very easy. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to do that. And don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching.